With me on the line now is Capital Network's oil and gas analyst, Lionel Therond, to take a look at Quadrise Fuels. Lionel, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
What do they do, first of all, Lionel? Tell me a bit more about them.
So Quadrise is a company which is engaged in the manufacture and marketing of synthetic, low-cost and environmentally friendly substitute to conventional heavy fuel. Now, the company doesn't actually manufacture the fuel, but they license their trademark MSAR technology to refining partners who then sell the fuel to the end customers. To give you an idea, the heavy fuel oil market is a huge market. It's a $100 billion market, global market, with some 455 million tons sold annually. The company targets two segments within that market. First of all, the marine fuel and also the power generation. So marine use is the larger segment with a 45% share of the market. It's also a segment which has high growth expectations. It is expected to grow by about 12% per annum by 2020.
Lionel, you mentioned there the MSAR technology. What does it stand for? Tell me a bit about it.
Okay, so MSAR stands for multiphase superfine atomized residue. And the fuel is essentially manufactured by mixing heavy residual oils from the refining process with small amounts of specialty chemicals and water to a bespoke formulation using proprietary technology. The IP itself is protected jointly with AkzoNobel, which is a global chemicals manufacturer through long-term partnership and agreements, which date back to 2000, I believe, and are regularly extended with a recent extension to at least November 2018.
Well, certainly sounds interesting. Critically, though, Lionel, what are the benefits of this technology?
Well, there are twofold. the first benefit is the low cost. It's a low-cost alternative to traditional heavy fuel oil. And the second one is the benefit to the environment. It's much environmentally friendlier than traditional heavy fuel. So first, looking at the cost. By using only water and chemicals, MSAR differs from the traditional manufacturing process for the heavy fuel oil, which uses a portion of the higher value distillates as diluents in the process. So that's the traditional method. Now, with MSAR, you don't use those higher value distillates, which means that the refiners can sell the entire slate of higher value distillate products, which obviously has a positive impact on revenue. Now, the difference between this increase in revenue and the variable cost of the MSAR process is positive for the refiner and also translates into a lower cost for the end user. The second cost element, cost advantage, is that the resulting emulsion is a low viscosity liquid at room temperature, which makes it easier to handle and reduces heating costs for the storing, transportation, and use in comparison to traditional heavy fuel oil. The second benefit is to the environment. The hydrocarbon droplets in the emulsion are significantly smaller than the droplets you find in heavy fuel oil, which means that when it's used, the MSAR fuel burns almost completely, which leaves virtually no particulate carbon in the exhaust, and that makes it obviously more environmentally friendlier. Now, the environmental benefits enable customers to remain compliant with the ever-stringent environmental regulation that we find, especially in the maritime environment, with respect to nitrogen oxides and also carbon particulate emissions. So those are the two essential benefits which makes it obviously very attractive compared to traditional fuel.
Certainly. What's the current status of this technology? Is it being used at the moment?
Okay, so Quadrise has not yet reached the commercial production stage. So they have developed the technology, and they are currently in the trial stage. So what they are doing, they are running two commercial scale trials, one in the maritime and one in power generation, together with partners. And subject to the positive results from those commercial scale trials, Quadrise could start delivering early stage commercial revenues during, say, 2017-2018.
Very good. Lionel, you've been taking a look at the numbers. What valuation do you put on Quadrise Fuels?
Okay, so yes, I've looked at it. I mean, obviously, the company is not yet producing, so obviously it has virtually no revenue and a negative free cash flow. And the question is, you know, how much value can be generated from this point onward? Now, the answer to that depends, obviously, on the success of the trials. So there's a probability there element, an option value, if you wish. And also, you know, contingent on that success, then you have to think about what the adoption ramp up of the MSAR fuel by customers in case of success. So one way to look at it, and that's what I've used in the report, is instead of looking at a value which is, you know, coming from a comprehensive bottom up model based on uncertain forecast on the future, what I've done is try to assess what the stock market price implies in terms of expectation for the company. So for these assessments, what I've done, first of all, I've applied the probability of success for the trial. So I've applied the probability of success of 2/3, saying, okay, I mean, it's likely those trials will be positive because I believe in the technology. But also I acknowledge the remaining risk for further delays or potentially failure, obviously. I have also used management guidance for an average gross margin for future production, and I've used a peer group value made of a universe of European and US specialty chemical stocks. Now, based on this analysis, I estimate that the current share price, which is about 10p, implies a yearly production volume equivalent to 7 to 8 units, similar to the one used in the maritime trial. Which would result in an EBITDA of about $10 to $15 million. Now, 7 to 8 units as a yearly production once the company, you know, is in full production mode, I believe that's quite a conservative assumption, if you wish, given the size of the market and the obvious competitive advantage of the technology. Therefore, I conclude that the current share price offers substantial optional value.
Just a final word, Lionel. You've had a few sit-downs with management. What do you like about them? What are you most impressed by?
If you look at the board, obviously Mike Kirk, the executive chairman, is a new addition. He's been there for a year or two, relatively new, but he's a chemical engineer with you know, wealth of background and experience in the space, and also with great banking experience. So he's been brought to take the company, obviously, to the next level once it starts commercial production. You have also two individuals, the CFO, Iman Tenawala, which is one of the founders, you know, very experienced financial professional, but also an entrepreneur. He was one of the founders of Nautical Petroleum, which is obviously one of the success story in the space in London. And you have also Jason Miles, which is the chief operating officer, which has a long career with BP and PDVSA, the Venezuelan oil company, which has a long history of these, you know, manufacturing this kind of oil water emulsion fuels. I'd say he worked with BP, has implemented numerous such projects globally. So, and he's been with the company also from the start. So, you know, very strong board, very experienced, seasoned professionals, and very good to talk to, very knowledgeable. So I was quite impressed by that.
Very good, Lionel. Capital Networks oil and gas analyst Lionel Therond there, looking through Quadrise Fuels.